Have you ever wondered if the place where you live has its very own original music? One type of music native to Washington, D.C. is called go-go music.
Give me the bridge now.
The godfather of go-go, Mr. Chuck Brown, and his group The Soul Searchers came out with this go-go hit all the way back in 1978. But it can still be heard at Wizards, Capitals, and Nationals games, plus at music venues and community events across the city to this day. Just recently, I teamed up with a group of local DC musicians to perform and teach you this song.
Hello, everybody! Welcome to Folks Music Live, celebrating the District of Columbia. Horns, are you guys ready to bust loose? They're ready. Are you all ready to bust loose? All right, here we go. A one, two, three, give it a bridge, y'all. I feel like busting loose, give it a bridge now. Come on, you know it, sing it back with me. I feel like busting loose, busting loose in the meantime. Busting loose makes you feel fine. Talking about busting loose, okay, your turn, here we go. Busting loose in the meantime, busting loose makes you feel fine. Talking about busting loose, here we go, we got more. Busting loose when you want to sing, busting loose, baby, do your thing. Talking about busting loose, here we go, your turn. Busting loose when you want to sing, busting loose, baby, do your thing. Give it a bridge now. Come, come on, give it a bridge now. I feel like busting loose, give it a bridge now. I feel like busting loose, here we go. Get on down. Get on up, y'all. Get on down. Get on down. What? Get on up, y'all. Get on down. Come on. I feel like busting loose.
While we celebrate Washington, D.C.'s folks music today, I think it's important to recognize the people and meaningful culture of this land long before it was called Washington, D.C. In the early 1600s, this land was home to a tribe called the Nacotchtank, which comes from the word Anaquashtank, meaning a town of traders. I think that one way we can honor the Nacotchtank and their culture is by striving to continue to be a town of traders, trading ideas, trading celebrations of one another, and trading turns caring for this land that has served as a home for thousands of years. Speaking of people that have called DC home, next let's celebrate an incredible musical and performing artist whose work has graced Washington, D.C. for years. Here's the one-of-a-kind Awa Sel Secka to share some of her folks music.
One thing I like to do on folks music is break the ice with our guests by asking about their name and where their name comes from. Does your name translate to something or mean something? Are you named after someone in your family or loved ones?
So my name, spelled A-W-A, translates to Eve. In Gambia, where my family is from, I'm first generation. Most of the country practices Islam, so I grew up Muslim. So Awa is to Eve as Adama is what we would call it in Gambia, is to Adam. So my name means Eve.
That's beautiful. I'd love for you to give some context of what does this song mean to you personally? What do you remember this being a particular musical memory, or is it more family? Describe how this song impacted your life and where it comes from for you.
For sure, 100%. So the song has a more recent history with me. It wasn't something that I experienced as a nursery rhyme or anything growing up with. I was doing a show and I was playing an East African in the show, and Gambia's West African, but my director at the time had asked, hey, can you see if there's a song culturally that has a lot of, like, you know, joy in it that we can use a short song for the show. So I went to my mom and I was like, hey, mommy, do you know any like African folk songs I can sing? And so she sings a song for me. And then I go, oh, that's a beautiful song. You know, it sounded sweet. It was beautiful. And then she was like, yeah, it's about, I can't remember how she said it, but she told me the story of the song, and it's not the happiest of endings. And it was a very funny, silly moment for the two of us.
As I've learned more and more folk songs, they can take something, what can maybe be a tragic tale,
yes,
into something that unites people and brings people together. I'd love for you to maybe tell a little bit about, tell that story of the song and more about it. We'd love to hear.
Absolutely. It'd be my pleasure. And I think, like, so with all the folk songs, I mean, folk songs and folk stories, folk tales that we know, there are so many different versions. Like, we know Disney's version of Cinderella, but that's not, like, maybe the Netherlands version of Cinderella or Germany's version of Cinderella or China's version of Cinderella. There are so many stories that kind of circulate in our different things, but are the same core and end in the same way with the same tale, with minor differences as we go. So the version of Masane Sise, which is the name of the story that I know, is not the version that the internet knows or other Gambians know. So I'm only going to share with you what I know. But basically, so the long and short of it is the story starts with a man. His name is Masane Sise. He's a very rich man, and the entire village knows him for this. They know his wealth, and some people think that it's consumed him, that he's become his money, and that he doesn't have any regard for people anymore, but other people know him as the kind person he was before they knew his money. But nobody told him what they thought about him. Nobody told him how they felt. They just felt how they felt about him, and they decided, well, he's got a lot of money, so I'm gonna be nice to him, because if he's deciding he wants to be nice today, I wanna be his friend. And Masane Sise, he decides that the village that he lives in is kind of, he's like, I've experienced enough here. I want to see more of the world, or I want to see more of this side of the world. And he travels to another village in Gambia, and he sees this beautiful woman, and he falls in love with her. It was love at first sight. And he goes to his friends that he knows in the village and goes, hey, so do you know if she's married? Like, could I, you know, court her? And they say, yes, but she is betrothed to someone else. And he decides, well, I think I have the money to convince her father to break that arrangement with this other gentleman and to allow me to marry her instead. And so he goes to the father, and they kind of, you know, the dad is a very proud man, and he's like, no, I'm gonna keep my arrangement, but then decides he needs the money and changes the arrangement, and the man who was to marry the daughter, the beautiful woman, gets very heartbroken and upset over it. And the version of the story that I know is that he went and cast a spell on Masane Sise for the day of the wedding. So fast forward to the day of the wedding, they go to get married, and Masane Sise passes away. And the beautiful woman sings for him there at the wedding the song of, this was the man that I was supposed to marry, this was the man I loved, and I lost him. So it is a sad story, but at the end, the village kind of comes together, the people that didn't think of him as the most savory of people per his wealth, and the people that did love him, and they remember him for all of the good that he was. Not the best of stories for the previous betrothed, but
well, it's so fascinating. And I think what's so interesting about this song, the little amount that I know about it, sure, is it talks about a river,
yes,
right, that runs through,
yes,
the Gambia. How do, what do,
yes,
you say?
So a lot of people say the Gambia, and I think that's the proper way to say it, but Gambian people are just like, Gambia. We just say Gambia.
That's great. So is it Bintang Bolong, is that how you say the name of the river?
So to my knowledge, yes, or it would, I think one, so let me also be clear. The language that the song is in, I believe is Mandinka. I speak Wolof. Mandinka is a tribe, but it's also a language that a lot of Gambian people speak. A lot of Senegalese people speak. A lot of people on the Ivory Coast speak, also in the Ivory Coast. But yes, so these lyrics, you'll hear a lot of Mandinka words as a Gambian person or a person who speaks Wolof, and you'll say, I know that word, and I know that word, but I don't know that word in the middle, and I know that word on the end. So yes, I believe Bintang Bolong is like the river of Bolong or the river of Bintang, one of the two.
Yeah,
yes.
From what I read online and the little amount when Awa shared with me this beautiful, tragic yet beautiful song, I think there was a quote, and I might be misquoting this, but it's like people go to that river to something about their minds, like calm their minds or figure things out. And it was just like, what a beautiful thing. Like, I don't know if the Potomac has such a noble effect. And I think just so beautiful, you know, one thing my fiance Lauren does that I love is cleanups, coastal cleanups, river cleanups. Yeah. And I think with this connection to humanity and nature and all these things coming together, this song is just so meaningful on so many levels.
Yeah.
I would love to have Awa sing it for us, maybe one time all the way through.
Great, yeah.
And then she can break down each part and take it away, Awa.
Awesome. So I'll sing it once through, and then I'll tell you what each of the lines on these on the both of the sides of the card mean. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise, masa nesise. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise, bintang bolong dalam asa nesise, manyo bekum bola ke ma belaring. Manyo bekum bola ke ma belaring. And that's the way the song in full goes. But for the first part of the song, Bintang Bolong Dala Masa Anesise, basically means Masa Anesise, the rich man we spoke about, is by or in the river of Bintang, which is where the wedding was said to have happened and where she mourned her husband. And then the back, Manyo Bekumbola Kema Belaring. Manyo means I came. Bekumbola means all the way to Kumbola. Kema Belaring is the part of the sentence that I don't know, but I can imagine. And what I have been translated to by my mother has been, I came to Kumbola to mourn my husband. So those are the full lyrics. And I'll sing it one more time through without stopping. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise, masa nesise. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise, bintang bolong dalam asa nesise, manyo bekum bola ke ma belaring. Manyo bekum bola ke ma belaring.
Yeah. Can you just give Awa a round of applause?
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
That is just, there's such, I mean, haunting beauty. I don't know how to describe
it. It's very eerie.
Yeah.
It's very, and rightfully so for the story. Yeah. But yes, I think haunting is the perfect word. Yes, there's a... And a piece to it, though, right? Like you said, people still go to Bintang Bolong to be pensive, to think, to, you know?
Right.
And that's exactly what she did. So,
beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay, can we break it down line by line? Like, let's see. Can everyone sing that with us? Bintang.
Yeah.
Ready? Here we go.
Bintang Bolong dalam asa nesise. Masa nesise.
We can do that again.
Yeah, let's do that again.
Bintang bolong dalam masa nesise. Masa nesise.
Beautiful. And I know, so the next part, we'd sing that again.
So the second part of the repetition of this would go, it would be the first part that we sang the first time. Bintang bolong dalam masa nesise. And then you would descend on the second. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise.
Ooh, can we do that? Can we do that descending line? Bintang. Ready? Go.
Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise.
Yeah.
Very good. Let's do that one more time. Can we do it even a little bit slower? One, two, three, one, two.
Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise.
Beautiful. Okay, let's go to the backside.
Yeah. This would be the most kind of wibbly wobbly of the lines if there was one. This one goes, Manyo Bekumbola. We can just do that part and then go on to the next if that's good.
That's great.
Yeah? One, two, three, and
Manyo Bekumbola.
Perfect. Awesome. And then the second would be Kemabelaring.
Kemabelaring.
Let's do this whole page one
Let's
time.
Let's do this one? Great.
Manyo Bekumbola Kemabelaring.
Here we go. Ready and go.
Manyo Bekumbola Kemabelaring.
Beautiful. Yeah. Lovely. I think we got it.
Let's stand up
yeah, and like
it.
Sing it?
Yeah.
Should we let you get started and then maybe we repeat
Great.
After you? Is that
yeah.
okay? Okay. So let Awa sing and come in with me.
Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise. Manyo Bekumbola Kemabelaring. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise. Bintang bolong dalam asa nesise. Manyo Bekumbola Kemabelaring.
Yeah.
That's really
yeah.
lovely.
Awesome.
Thank you so much,
Thank
Awa.
You.
This has been so. Can we give Awa another round of applause?
Thank you.
So wonderful. So special.
Thank you so much for joining us today as we've celebrated those who put the folks in Washington, D.C.'s folks music. Before we go, we're going to celebrate one more D.C. and worldwide music icon, Mr. Duke Ellington. In fact, our horn section features two musicians from the Duke Ellington School of the Arts, whose home is right here in Washington, D.C., Miss Sophia Smith on trumpet and Mr. Hakim Bristow on tenor sax.
Awa and Dan, take it away.
Thank you.
Music is a world within itself, with a language we all understand, with an equal opportunity for all to sing, dance, and clap their hands.
One, two, three.
But just because the music has a groove, don't make it folks music.
What?
But you can tell right away it led to A when the people start to move.
Come on!
They can feel it all over. They can feel it all over, people. They can feel it all over. They can feel it all over, people.
Go!
Just won't quit. But here are some of music's pioneers that time will not allow us.
us to forget now.
Well, there's Basie, Miller, Louis Armstrong, and the king of all, Sir Duke. And with a voice like Awa's ringing out, there's no way the band can lose. Come on!
You can feel it all over. You can feel it all over, people.
Come on!
You can feel it all over. You can feel it all over, people.
Come on!
You can feel it all over. You can feel it all over, people. You can feel it all over. Everybody, all over, people. Feel it all over. Everybody.